Eleanor and I did. Yeah.
And the mask?
Yeah, Eleanor designed the rabbit masks that I see right now. And then we also had Cooper, the TD, do helping us with construction of some stuff. So, yeah, we are a little trio going.
Johnson, come closer.
Thank you. Trying to give you a good reason for leaving. Retroactively. Hey, I just wanted to let you know that I'm leaving tomorrow. If you decide to take any parental responsibility, it'll have to be through this phone. I can give you an address if you want, once I figure out what that's gonna be. I used to think it was because there was something out there that just pulled harder than needed here, something worth seeking. But I get it. You just didn't care about what was here, so you bet on something better out there. With Grandma gone now, I get it. But I still waited for her. Were we not good enough?
Stop calling me! No, don't call me on my off hours, and don't use my personal number. And don't think for a second I'm letting you fuck over your kid. No, I'm not giving up. I'm not gonna give up. You are not giving up.
Okay, come on.
We all gotta be getting somewhere.
Yeah, amen. Excuse me? I'll tell you why. Oh.
You humans frequently are difficult to understand, but we do our best.
I don't think humans are that difficult to get. I mean, most of them mean well.
Ooh, not so sure about that.
The humans are gone, still learning.
Your figures haven't gone insane the day before I'm supposed to leave.
Oh, another fire stick. But I thought you didn't have any left.
I told you they're called smoke sticks. And that was a lie. Humans have a thing for lying.
They are simply learning. Besides, truth sees no single form. Smoke stick, fire stick. They're both equally true before I can't even continue to lie.
That was Socrates. And now I think my son would be so well spoken.
And self-obsessed.
Well, it's only natural that a human would be confused. They rarely see us these days.
They choose not to. Choose was the wrong word. They're too distracted most of the time, and what they're distracted by is themselves. Self-obsessed.
You're not a hallucination?
Even if we were, who's to say hallucinations aren't a vision of another truth?
This can't be real.
Perhaps not real in the sense that you're used to. But what is reality but a collection of things we expect?
Yeah, I'm completely lost.
You see, our expectations begin to form new information.
Listen, Roots, let's save the abstractions for later. A demonstration might be more helpful. For example, I can speak from here, or over there, or here. It's all the same, really, only a matter of where I choose to ground myself. Existence is so much simpler without human form.
Oh! Where did they come from?
They're always here.
You just can't see them.
Best not to question it. Don't want to hurt your brain too bad when you've already got a heart in that bad a condition. Look, don't get me wrong. You were taking this way better than I would have expected.
Much better than most people.
What metric are you measuring that by?
Oh, far too many encounters to pull from, in my opinion.
Granted, you all have changed quite a bit as of recently.
What constitutes recently for a tree?
A tree spirit, dear.
From what I gather, it is understood even by humans that your ability to perceive has dropped drastically after the birth of
Televisions?
Technologies, and it was before that. You all went downhill at around the time of your great moving machines, if you ask me. Went and forgot you had your own two legs.
Why am I getting a sense I'm not welcome here?
It's all in good humor. We adore you, I can promise that.
We do need each other to breathe, don't we?
Huh. I hadn't thought about it like that.
There's always an angle that's not considered.
So, can she see you?
Let's find out. She can sense something's changed. The wind sounds a bit too musical. The sky just turned her exact favorite shade of bluish purple. Maybe the ground lifts to meet her feet as she walks.
So you're good spirits. What is with you and all these rules? You never seem to pay them any mind in your own realm.
Don't be afraid. Right, there is nothing to do.
Huh. Yeah, you might have to do some convincing.
No, 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 let me go. I don't know what you want, but I have some water. Hey, wait, I have a tangerine.
My aim would never be to hurt you. I must apologize for the parts of myself. You see, they thought you were one of my own by how your heart was racing. I see now you are human, lost, and understandably afraid.
Oh, listen, I've had a stressful day enough without whatever this is, so I'll just be on my way.
I wouldn't advise that. Oh, sorry to frighten you further. You see, it is of utmost importance that you do not leave now. If you do, you will be walking into eternal twilight.
Eternal Twilight?
Mm-hmm. How do I make it make sense? I'm not old. Imagine being lost forever. Basically, it will not be good for your soul.
Okay. Well, I have to make a quick phone call, so I'll just be
the signal. It doesn't transfer well through different layers.
Why today? What did I do wrong?
It must be the pressure. I'm cracking under the pressure. I need to go home.
I know this must be confusing.
But we must understand that very rare for humans to visit us. So you must forgive me for trying to put you at ease. Soon, the sun will set, and the doorway between our worlds will close.
I think it is best if you come with me. I will make sure you're not the last. Is
this one of yours? Did you invite them here? Considering I don't know where here is, no. I did not bring them here.
What were you smoking?
Yeah, it doesn't work like that.
You've entered our lair. Welcome.
Word. Okay. Well, this has been absolutely terrifying, so I'm gonna head, but...
You missed the exposition! We can't leave!
What? Why?
No need to worry. You see, we are about to have a festival, and besides, we could use some extra pair of hands.
Oh, A festival, okay. What are we celebrating?
Dusk!
That is very anticlimactic.
Dusk is a signifier of the cycle. It's proof that you survived another day, surpassed the challenges that chained you to the past. You see, I've lived through every day in existence. Dusk is a reason to celebrate.
Well, I guess it's only until night, and the alternative is getting lost forever. Festival, what is it that needs to be prepared?
Food and drink. Come, let's get everything cooked.
Something on the mind. Being a tree spirit, do you feel particularly close to flowers or plants in general, I guess?
Oh, yes. Flowers make for great conversation. They're a very positive bunch. You see, even though all of us plants are quite different, we are still quite close. Even ferns.
What's the deal with ferns? Ooh, they tend to flaunt their seniority over other plants.
Young. The ferns are young, and so they get caught up in these things.
What is it? This, like, killing them? Grass and the flowers?
Killing, a very human concept.
Humans are the only thing that die. Plants die, humans die, it's inevitable.
Plants don't tend to see the self in life as finite as humans are. Death is merely transformation. The tree may fall, but its soul and energy keep moving as its nutrients continue to provide life.
Not sure applicable nutrients are to people, but...
The nutrients were a metaphor. A point was the transformation.
Transformation is a huge privilege. Every autumn, I fall to the ground, sink into it, become it. Then, only when I am the tiniest version of myself, do I meet roots again, climb my way up trunk, and bud again to greet the sun.
Again, not entirely relevant to people, but it's beautiful.
That's not what I meant.
To live is to change. The best we can hope is that our change never goes.
When we do this death, we're going to energy in order to do so.
Justify all the things that have happened to you rather than demand the life you deserve.
Listen, you don't know about anything that's happened to me. And whatever I may or may not deserve has never been what I've gotten. You learn to expect reality pretty quickly when that's all that's been given to you.
All of this is great, but it doesn't mean shit for what happens when I clock in. It doesn't mean shit for what I've experienced, and it doesn't mean shit for how people really are. Look, this is nice. More peaceful than I felt in a while. But I am not going to pretend that some tree spear, which I'm pretty sure is a sign for me finally snapping, holds any answers to my real problems. Real life isn't like this, and yes, I know, what is real life anyhow? It doesn't matter what I call it, it matters what I have to live when I leave here.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings. I just got excited, and then I started talking too much. Stupid. Of course you're gonna hurt her feelings. Why couldn't you keep your thoughts in? What do you know anyways? The sun. The sun. I know the sun.
I shouldn't have gone off like that. It's just everybody is always telling me who I am and what I have to be. And a fucking tree piling onto that. Yeah.
Yes, you're gonna say that first. But you've come to a giving caring. Moments where you don't catch yourself, you guys were something better than you.
Well, all humans do, when they love themselves. That's the problem with you people, so fixated on proving yourselves to be what you imagine, you never let yourselves be who you truly are.
Well, whatever I am or imagine, it matters how other people are. And yeah, I'd love to believe that people are good deep down and all, but if they don't show it, it doesn't matter much. All I know is what I've been given, and I've been given shit for 28 years.
Very young.
Young or not, it's what I know.
You had a grandma, correct?
You were listening?
Of course we were. Very difficult to miss things with so many ears.
Well, okay, yeah, fine. I'll give you one person. One person who saw the beauty in others. One person who insisted on my worth. One beautiful person who her daughter left to her granddaughter to take care of and couldn't remind either of their names in the end. So yeah, one person. But she's gone now.
Not gone.
She clearly still lives in your kindness.
Well, all of our kindness combined and stopped my mom from leaving.
But you stayed, right?
Well, yeah. I did.
So? She stays with you.
I'm leaving tomorrow.
I think you may have misheard earlier. You can leave once the sun goes down.
God, why am I saying I'm leaving here, this place?
Ooh, a trip. That's exciting!
One of the joys of being human, quite exciting.
Where are you going? I honestly don't know. I just don't know why I've been stuck here, you know? Of course you know, I'm talking to a fucking tree.
Following your mother?
No. Maybe. I don't know. I just know that I've never been given a choice. By the time I was old enough, I had to take care of my grandma and this is the only time I've had nothing holding me here. No reason not to run.
So then it is running away?
I guess. What else would it be?
Running towards.
You are full of shit.
I've always suspected that.
That very well may be.
We ran out of flowers.
Oh my god. I got so curious. I'll go get more.
No, wait, you might get-
No, I'm fine! I'm in the hang of it around here.
Oh, humans. Always making things so much more complicated for themselves.
Just learning so fast. A little care and they open up like flowers in the spring.
Spring.
Humans, huh? Will they be okay?
Yes.
No.
Maybe.
On people like that.
Well, I thought you could see me. Didn't mean to offend you in any way, my apologies.
Don't have eyes in the back of my head, unfortunately.
I do.
Oh my god, I'm fine. Yeah, no, this is what I get for wishful thinking, isn't it?
What do you mean by that?
I'm sorry, I think it's something for folks with two eyes or less to understand. Sorry.
I understand, no need to explain. She says you've been dancing all night.
Who?
Up there. Miss Moon.
Okay.
The Moon.
I'm sorry. I didn't want to laugh. It's just, you know, different here and where I'm from. Not so many inanimate objects.
All that, will you still see them as lifeless?
No. No, I mean, come on, you know what I mean.
It's no. Like, and our planes, they're not so different.
But
when I have to.
Could she hear what I was dancing to?
No, a bit too far away, unfortunately. Says you danced with joy unmatched tonight. Where has all that joy run off to?
You know what, the big bunny thing said you were prepping for a party tonight or something, right? So, what can I help with?
If you look in that bramble over there, you will find gloves. I'd get them out myself, but I'd like to keep flying if you don't mind. You are going to need to unscrew all the lids. I left them on pretty tightly last time, so...
Thanks. So now what?
We need to gather a few different winds this evening. Let's see. Gust, breeze, puff, current, draft, and flurry. Well, we may have some difficulty finding that one tonight. It's been so lovely out recently.
So what, just like pull them up like this? Or...
That's perfect. Okay. You will know exactly when to put them away.
How will I know?
Intuition.
Bold of you to trust me, then.
You will do great. Dancing, in your world, it's a form of celebration, isn't it?
I'd say usually, yeah. Or it's like a way to get out some extra energy, you know, that sort of thing.
What were you celebrating today?
Do you have love here?
No. No, what's that?
Okay, what? First off, I don't love her, or like, I don't want to say that out loud, so I'm not completely sure yet. I mean, you know how it goes. Or God, wait, I guess you don't, if you don't have love here. God, that would be so much simpler. But anyways, I'm seeing her tonight, and you know, I'm kind of nervous, because it's not like a everyday type of thing, you know what I mean?
Right.
But, think about it. Wait, do you know that feeling when you, like, played out so many different imaginary scenarios of the person, and then you see them in person, but then you, like, unintentionally start acting like that set of imaginary memories, and they actually come?
But you are just delusional?
Wait,
I'm still trying to understand. Be patient.
I'm not explaining this right. I'm sorry.
Keep trying.
Okay. Imagine... Imagine you see everyone you've ever known, just like a big white pool.
What?
Stay with me, right? Imagine everyone you've ever known is lined up in front of you, a big white void, and certain people light up. Certain people have a big old halo of lights around them because they're doing to a different future. It's so strong.
And let it that time moving on and having new experience.
And joy.
You are holding on so tightly. You are the human personification of white knuckles.
It's time dedicated to fostering the potential for relationships.
Get stubborn.
This is her favorite song, too.
Well, tell her she has great taste.
You have great taste!
What's your name? What do you want the people?
Oh, Gregor. Spirits.
My name. Well, I suppose mine is a little more difficult than some of the others. It's not so much a thing as the water or the wind. More of an idea. More of something that can't be held, but can be felt.
So you're not right. A rabbit spirits?
No, they are.
Oh, you're the rabbit spirits!
No! I'm all connections that can be made.
So the rabbit spirit connection.
Here it is, the rabbits. But I am anywhere upon this nature. Think of a classroom.
Of course, you are a teacher.
Just a lucky guess. A classroom becomes one, not because the room itself holds some magic property of learning. Students are students because of the teacher, and the teacher is made a teacher by the students. Here, when these two things come together, a bond is made. When they come together, they're greater than their individual parts. They create a relationship that has a life and a heartbeat of its own.
That's a very sweet thought.
Just a thought. No being is a being. We are created and create because of the relationships we have.
That may be how you describe things here, but I don't know. The world just feels a lot lonelier than what you describe it.
Loneliness is a feeling. It doesn't mean you're not connected.
It's not just a feeling. The way the world works is lonely. Lonely people shifting between disconnected places, trying to make things work, but they never do. And the worst is how lonely the kids are and how can it help them.
What is that?
You try to provide for them. You know, you try to give them hope. You try to give them space. Materials won't be provided by the school, so you provide them. You won't get paid for the extra hour, so you make the time that every meeting, it feels more and more like a community thing. You say that no pain is an ending. You have to
go to work. Why do you stay? If this frustrates you so deeply, why don't you just leave?
Well, I conclusively proved that college was a waste of time.
So, it's a formality.
No. So, that's not what I meant. I stay for the kids. I study. I know what it's like to be a teacher. What it cares. It can change your life. It changed my life. It's just hard. And it feels like I'm peering into a void. It feels more and more.
A lot of pressure. Too much for just a blunt shoulder.
Unfortunately, it's the only pain I really need.
Is that really the case? Have you asked?
No, I haven't had to ask. I know how those teachers are. It's just a paycheck to them. Not even a good one of them.
But you haven't asked.
No, I haven't.
Outside of the school?
Listen, everybody has problems. It's nobody's fault, but I can't ask somebody to add mine to their own.
So you haven't asked. You asked so many questions, but not from us.
I had waited for hope. I never would have made it as far as I did. I have had to make everything happen for all of my life.
But the teacher,
what?
She has showed you the importance that relationship can have.
That's true.
So, not all alone.
That's one.
How are you to give the children that same relationship if you yourself can't trust others?
Because I put everything on the line for my kids. It seems easy being on whatever you are, whatever this is. But don't tell me what I can and can't give. Do you have any idea how hard it is to go in every day and try to give these kids something to be excited about and care about when the whole world is telling them that it doesn't care? Do
idea, any idea how hard that is.
The world cares.
If it does, then I'd love to see it.
It's happening right now.
Listen, I can't do this. No, I get I can't leave or I'll get lost, but please let me sit down somewhere until this nightmare is over.
You won't reach out for them. Even when they're here, just to carry some of the weight. That's all we want. Was a girl. A while back. In a time like today, when a girl would spend hours here with carrots and celery that she would smuggle from her lunchbox. A time where for weeks she would offer them to the rabbits who gathered here. They were timid, fearing what humans can be and are towards something as delicate as a rabbit. But over time, they began to trust, began to edge forward, and finally grab from the girl's outstretched hand. As they grew more bold, and the girl kept coming, a new bond was formed. A connection birthed in this park, and unique to the girl and the rabbit she had befriended. A connection that, while neglected, has never faded. The earth never stopped caring. You just have to listen. They say you are alone is to deny the bonds that are there and ready to catch you. Sometimes we forget things in order to convince ourselves of their opposite. Now, we have everything prepared. So, are we ready to make the stew? Are you ready? We are here whenever.
I think I'm ready.
Oh! My face.
So this happens every night?
Oh, for as long as I can remember.
How long is that?
A while.
Get out your lights.
What?
Get them ready.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
I didn't expect that thing to be coming here so soon.
Why do you keep calling it that thing? Solving all these tasks.
Fantastic, sure, but the thing harshes the vibe every cycle. We haven't had one good celebration since it turned.
One can only be saved by an extended hand. But indeed, this has complicated things.
What is going on?
You all felt that, right? I mean, that was
wrong. Something's very wrong. I don't feel well.
Look, if we don't get an explanation, we'll take our chance in the space between our worlds or whatever you just said. Something isn't right.
And we truly have your kind to thank for things.
Don't be mean. It's not their fault.
Well, they didn't start it, but you know how they are.
It just needs help. We have to help it.
You can't help something that doesn't wish to be helped.
But it can't work for something that it doesn't deserve.
Maybe it's us. Maybe we haven't been trying hard enough.
Us. After everything it has
done. The young could be blamed for their inexperience.
Silence!
Sorry, she couldn't hear herself think.
To be alarmed is expected, but this is only...
What is that? What is that?
Our world is not free from problems of its own, you see. Though we enjoy and seek peace, sometimes we feel the ripples of your world and ours. Sometimes that happens.
But what exactly is that? I get that being vague is the thing around here, but you have to take some responsibility and look at the state it's in. Haven't we been helping that? We have a right to know. It's the human spirit.
Don't hiding the truth would only hurt its name.
They must know in order to change it.
Well, when the world's been turning recently, I wouldn't be surprised to hear that they already knew.
Why did it look like that? Who did that? You did. No. This harm has been years in the making.
When humans forgot to care for each other, it lost the ability to care for itself.
Then we can help it now. No use.
It'll run away.
I wonder where I learned that.
This is who we are? The sum of everything? This is what we look like here?
It wants to join.
Get it away from me.
It has every right to
be. No, I'm sorry. I need to leave right now.
We can't go yet, remember?
No, I don't need to
child tell me that I can and can't do it in time.
Look, he's just trying to help.
Okay, well, this child is falling over himself into a sad-looking rag thing and knows enough to, I don't know, not go running off into the magical spirit wild. There's probably more shit like this running around in there.
Stop proving them right! You're hurting it.
I don't know how to help it.
Lead the way.
It hurts.
Imagine all that it could be.
It hurts. It wasn't always this way. When you first came around, you were the biggest of them all. So much more potential than we had ever seen before. The only spirit I've met who's gotten that close to flying.
Flying.
And the cooking. The smells. You could take dirt, mulch, compost, you name it, and make any dish in the world.
An excellent conversationalist, too. The world seemed to stop whenever you'd speak.
Always so eager to find something new. Every corner of the planet became a journey, a dream, and eventually a home.
Knew how to set up a punchline.
There once was a forest, hidden in plain sight, right in front of the rest of the world.
It was home to all kinds of spirits. The most powerful of all, however, was the human spirit. Its heart beat the fastest, its thoughts ran the wildest, and the sun shone brighter every time it broke a smile.
Unlike the other spirits, the human spirit wasn't defined by its environment. It could shape it. Its hands could transform and express and give life to what was lifeless. Reach into the void and draw out color, music, dance, performance. Not content to let things simply be, the human spirit sought to name everything. To capture the beauty of everything it laid its eyes on with words. It wore rose-colored glasses, and they were still harmless.
I don't know what
do you think I did?
I'm not big enough.
Say anything.
There was once a spirit a long, long time ago. It always paused at tree corners and stopped to listen silently to shots. It smiled at strangers and smuggled carrots and celery from its lunchbox to give to its friends.
A spirit that could never figure out its feelings, but hasn't stopped trying.
A spirit that still stays, even when it's been left behind.
I miss the way that my branches used to hold you up as you all looked at the stars.
I miss when you used to run so fast you couldn't hear me singing.
I miss the way you'd stare up at the sky and how you'd show me all the shapes in the clouds.
Remember, you gave us music, taught us how to dance. Don't let yourself fizzle out. Without remembering who you really are, you felt so lonely without the togetherness that you once brought to us.
I think I can do that.
That was true.
You heard them. When the sun sets, the celebration ends.
No. It can't be over. It can't be over.
Sometimes things end before you're ready for them to. I sound like the fucking tree.
Do you think he'll be okay?
Yeah, he'll be fine. Although I've never left the spirit world, but...
Should we help him? Give him some time. He'll come around.
Right, space to sort things out.
Right.
It's okay. Well, just sit down.
No. I was mid-conversation. I still haven't figured out what I'm supposed to do tonight.
What's tonight?
Oh, there's this girl.
Oh!
No, not like that, or maybe like that. I don't know, hopefully, eventually, like that. God, I managed to access the spirit world, and I spent the whole night talking about a girl. What kind of idiot does that?
Oh, no, don't say that. That's sometimes necessary.
I was too focused on tonight to even think straight, and I mean, I'm still terrified.
After all of that, you're afraid of a girl?
I can still make it.
Better hurry then.
Yes. Right. Yes. Not because I'm stubborn, but because I want to.
Right.
Uh-huh. Yes. Not because I'm fighting the wind, but because I'm moving with the wind.
Exactly.
Thank you.
Yeah. Go!
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
I forgot how hungry I was after all that.
Tangerine? Absolutely.
Do you still want to smoke?
Oh, no. I think I'm going to stick to my guns.
Yeah. Fair enough.
Ow! I forgot tomorrow's lesson plan. And I haven't even begun to figure out how to fix the gardening club.
Well, slow down. I don't know if you need any help, but I'm free after 5 tomorrow if you can. I don't know what I can do.
Do you know anything about gardening? I need the help and I can't keep paying for the tools myself.
Well, my grandma had the green thumblet. She taught me a few things. I actually think I have a lot of her stuff in storage.
No, I couldn't ask.
No, I'd be happy to. I'm not getting any good use out of them. Besides, I'd be happy to lend a hand. I don't know. I've been running away from the things that make me happy for long enough.
Thank you.
Yeah.
No, I really appreciate that. And it's hard, you know, rallying all those kids together.
Oh my god, I can imagine.
And of course, you can always reconsider.
No, I won't reconsider.
Thank you. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, whenever you need help, let me know.
Well, I do have to go. But
no, I will. I'll see you here tomorrow.
I'll see you tomorrow.
See you then.
Yeah.